Good morning, children. Today we will do sexual reproduction in humans. Now, sexual reproduction in humans, we generally say that the sexual reproduction in boys and girls, it starts, we can say, at the age of puberty. Now, first of all, you should know what is puberty. Now, puberty, as it is defined, it is the age at which the reproductive organs, they become functional. That is, they start producing gametes, and number two is hormones. So whenever the boys and girls, their gametes are produced and hormones are produced, we say that they have attained the age of puberty. And if you know the rough estimate, boys, they attain puberty at the age of 13 to 14 years. And the girls, they attain puberty at the age of 10 to 12 years. So girls generally mature earlier than the boys. So now, due to puberty, some changes, they take place in the boys and the girls. Followed? And there are some changes in their physical appearance also, as well as there is some change in their, you can say, emotional feelings also, their brain also changes. So those changes which develop in the boys and the girls at the age of puberty, they are called as the secondary sexual characters. Follow? Now we will do, for example, we will give one example, boys, there is deepening of voice, their voice, it deepens in boys. They have a thick, coarse voice. Sometimes when they speak, it looks very odd that a boy is speaking. Number two, their body becomes more muscular. Their shoulders, they broaden. There is broadening of their shoulders and there is hair growth on their face. Hair growth on their face. So this is the characters which appear. They are called as the secondary sexual characters. Means after the sexual development starts, these characters they develop in the boys. And the girls also, they show very, there is a fat deposition in their bodies. They start attaining weight, gaining weight. Then as their voice changes, the voice of the girls becomes somewhat shrill. And there is onset of menstruation. This is very important. Onset of menstruation, which marks the beginning. Then there is development of breasts in the girls. So these are some of the changes that take place during puberty in the boys and the girls. Now, if we describe the male reproductive system in the boys, let us describe the male reproductive system. We will take the case of the boys now. First is, there are various parts of this. We will do them a little bit. Number one, they are the testes. Followed. Number second organ in the male reproductive system is the epididymis. Number three is the vas deferens. And number four, there are other male accessory glands. They are the, now these are the testes, they are the main gland, you can say gonads, main gland of the males, but there are accessory glands like the seminal vesicles, followed prostate glands, and the Cowper's glands are there. Cowper's glands are there. We will see their functions also. Followed. Now first of all, let us do the testes. Testes. Now children, testes, you know, they always occur in pairs. There are two testes in the boys, and these testes, they are present in a sac which is called as the scrotum. Scrotum, it lies outside the abdomen. This is very, very important. It is an abdomen outside the abdomen. Now the thing is, why the testes, they lie outside the abdomen, why not inside the abdomen? It is because whenever the sperm formation takes place, the sperm formation, they require a 3 degrees Celsius lower temperature lower temperature than the body. So that is very, very necessary for the development of the sperm. That is why they develop outside the scrotum. Now, if we see the functions of the testes, number one, they produce the male gametes called the sperms. Now, if you see sperms, mostly they are very small in size, microscopic, and they are motile. Why they are motile? Because they have to move to the female gamete. And how they can move? They have a tail which helps the sperm in movement. So naturally, sperms, they have got the different portions, that is the head, the middle piece, and the tail. So tail helps the sperms in movement. Number two function, the testes, they produce the male sex hormone called testosterone. Now this testosterone, it is this hormone that is responsible for the development of secondary sexual characters in the boys. Follow? Now the second is the epididymis. I will show you in the diagram also. For first you see epididymis. Now what is epididymis? It is nothing else but it is a coiled tube that arises from the testes, and it is you can say a little bit attached to the testes. It is attached to testes. Now what is its function? It is a temporary storehouse of sperms. So we can say that maturation of the sperms, it takes place in the testes. Followed over here, sorry, epididymis, maturation takes place over here. Now, third is the vas deferens, children. Again, there are two vas deferens. Since there are two testes, two vas deferens are there. So one arising from each side. So this vas deferens, it connects the prostate glands. It connects the prostate glands to seminal vesicles. Again, they are the accessory glands. Seminal vesicles. So they attach and they also transfer the sperms. Main thing is that they transfer the sperms to the urinogenital duct. So the sperms are transferred through this vas deferens. So I call urinogenital duct, but it's nothing but it is a common duct for the passage of urine and sperm in the males. And the seminal vesicles, which I have talked about, the accessory glands, they provide nourishment to the sperms. So their secretion, it also lubricates the passage through which the sperms travel. So they also provide mobility to the sperms. Followed? So seminal vesicles, they are important. The secretions of seminal vesicles, accessory glands, plus sperms, secretions of accessory glands, these seminal vesicles, all we have done, plus sperms, together they are called as the semen. What we call it as? Together they are called as the semen. Now I will show you the diagram of the male reproductive system. You can see the diagram. This is the testes. Singular is with IS, plural is with ES. So testes, here it is a outer sac or scrotum. Here it is the epididymis. This is the epididymis, followed epididymis. Then you can see the vas deferens is going on around the urinary bladder. See, here seminal vesicles are there. It takes the secretions from the seminal vesicles, takes the urine from the urinary bladder. It becomes a common duct. Now see, it becomes a common urinogenital duct. It enters the penis and urethra. It comes in the penis, it becomes the urethra to pass out the urine and sperms. Here are the prostate glands also. So this is, in this way, the sperms, they are produced in the testes, they mature in the epididymis, they are carried by the vas deferens, secretions are added from the seminal vesicles and the prostate glands, and then they come through the urinogenital duct. So this is about the male reproductive system. Now children, next we will do the female reproductive system. female reproductive system. Now, female reproductive system, it consists of different organs. Number one is the ovaries, followed number two is the fallopian tubes. Fallopian tubes are also known as the oviducts. Followed, and number three is the uterus. Number four is the vagina or the birth canal. Followed, now let us see the ovaries. Ovaries, children. Now, if you see the ovaries, they are again, they occur in pairs like the testes. But now, the ovaries, they are present inside the abdomen, not outside the abdomen. They are always inside the abdomen, ovaries. And they are almond-shaped structures are their ovaries. And these ovaries, they form the female gametes called eggs or ova. And this ova, it is large and mostly stores food. Followed. Secondly, they secrete the female sex hormone called estrogen. Estrogen, it helps in the development of the secondary sexual characters. And number two is the progesterone. Another hormone is there. Two hormones are there. Progesterone, it helps in maintaining pregnancy. It takes part in the pregnancy, this hormone. Number two is the fallopian tubes or oviducts. Now again they occur in pairs and they receive the egg. Egg is released by the ovary. Ovary releases the egg. When the ovary releases the egg, this process is called as ovulation. Followed, ovary releases the egg and this egg is carried by the fallopian tubes, followed, or the oviducts. So the main important function of the fallopian tubes, which I want to discuss here, is that fertilization takes place in the oviducts or fallopian tubes. Generally, children, the question is asked, what is the site of fertilization? It is the oviduct. Sometimes children, they write wrongly that it is the uterus. It is wrong. Fertilization always occurs in the oviduct or the fallopian tubes. Okay, next is the uterus. Now uterus, again, it is a thick walled muscular organ in which the embryo gets implanted. You know, when the fertilization takes place, zygote is formed. Zygote divides many times to form the embryo, and its embryo from the fallopian tubes, it moves down to the uterus, and here it gets implanted in the uterus, and here it develops for 9 months during pregnancy. The opening of the uterus is known as the cervix. Opening of the uterus is called as the cervix. Now, next is that the vagina or the birth canal. It is a short tube through which the baby is delivered. Short tube through which the baby is delivered, children. Followed? Now I will show you the diagram of the female reproductive system. You can see this diagram. Here you can see the ovaries. Ovaries, they release one egg every month. For that, the egg is received by these oviduct or fallopian tubes. It is called as ovulation. If the sperms meet the eggs over here, then fertilization takes place, zygote is formed, and it starts dividing to form the embryo. Then the embryo, it comes down the oviduct, it becomes 32 cell stage, then becomes a blastocyst sometimes, and it gets implanted over here in the uterus. In the wall of the uterus, it gets implanted, it gets fixed. So this is how the fertilization takes place and the embryo gets implanted in the oviduct. Now children, this you can see this thickened lining of the uterus. Can you see this? This is the thickened lining of the uterus. Now every month the uterus, it prepares itself, it gets thickened with the blood vessels to receive the fertilized egg. For example, If the fertilization occurs, I have told you implantation will occur. But if fertilization does not take place, then what will happen? Now this thickened lining is needed no longer. So it will break up, it will come down as the mucus and blood, followed which is termed as the menstruation. And it lasts for about 2 to 8 days. Every month this happens. Now the thing is, if the embryo gets implanted, how does the embryo get nourishment from the mother's blood? There develops a special tissue over here, which is called as the placenta, between the growing embryo and the mother. This special tissue is called as the placenta. It develops between the growing embryo and the maternal tissue. On the fetus side there are villi, and on the mother side there are the blood spaces. Through this placenta, the child gets the glucose and oxygen. Followed, so it absorbs, you can say, the glucose and oxygen from the mother's blood, and all at the same time it also releases the waste material, followed, as well as carbon dioxide, which is passed from the fetus to the mother's blood. Followed, so this is how the development of the baby takes place with the help of the placenta.